Right to participate. Health and safety representatives. Introduction. Before taking this module, you should be familiar with the Internal Responsibility System, IRS. Once it is understood that everyone in the workplace is personally and directly responsible for health and safety as part of his or her job, then the role of the Health and Safety Representative, H&S Rep, should become clear. You should also have taken the first Right to Participate module, in which the manner in which the H&S Rep is selected was covered. The Internal Responsibility System. The starting point is the IRS. The H&S Rep helps to fulfill the worker's right to participate. The worker's right to participate is a right to be represented in OHS matters. Everyone has a duty to participate in OHS. A worker may or may not exercise his or her right to participate by seeking the assistance of the H&S Rep. Even if no worker ever contacted the H&S Rep personally, the H&S Rep still functions as the worker's H&S Rep. The H&S Rep is a watchdog or auditor on behalf of workers. The H&S Rep does workplace inspections in order to check whether the employer has done a good job on inspections. The H&S Rep makes sure the employer is doing a good job on investigating and handling a worker's unsafe work refusal. When a serious accident occurs and the MOL inspector is called in, the H&S Rep is present as well to keep an eye on things. The H&S Rep accompanies the inspector on routine inspections in order to provide the inspector with some guidance and insight as to what is going on in the workplace. Direct and indirect responsibility. In all of the H&S Rep's activities, the H&S Rep is not directly responsible for OHS. No one should be counting on the H&S Rep to fulfill his or her own OHS responsibilities. Under the IRS, the employer and everyone as an individual are the direct contributors to OHS. The H&S Rep is indirectly responsible. The H&S Rep assists, consults, checks, audits, advises, watches, mediates, liaises, and many other words. The three worker rights, including the right to participate, are part of the IRS. They are not the main part. The IRS is a system, and all systems need feedback and fail-safe mechanisms to keep operating. It is impossible for the main part of the IRS to work perfectly on its own. The role of the H&S Rep, overall, is to keep the IRS on track. Without the main part of the IRS working, the employer and everyone as an individual, a H&S Rep would have an impossible task doing OHS alone. No single person or small group of people can replace the power of everyone doing OHS all the time. The H&S Rep has a critical role to play in OHS, but it is not the role some people think. There is a tendency for some people to think that they've transferred their OHS duties to the H&S Rep. They think that the H&S Rep is their agent, and they can now relax and not think about OHS. Some employers may think they only have to keep the H&S Rep happy and not be concerned with the potential contributions of individuals.